Hello student, in this video we are going to discuss about neoplasia. Since neoplasia is a very huge subject, we are going to cover it in a two videos. So in this video we are going to concentrate on what is neoplasia, what are the different types of neoplasias are there, what is the definitions of neoplasia and what are the characteristics of tumor. We are going to complete this in this video. So neoplasia literally means it's a new growth, but then all the new growth which is occurring inside our body does not come under the category of neoplasia. It can be either embryogenesis or, you know, repair and regeneration, or due to new growth due to hormonal stimulation. So that kind of growth doesn't come under the category of neoplasia. So the exact definition for neoplasia can be: a neoplasia is abnormal mass of tissue that grow and exceed in an uncontrolled manner as compared to the normal tissue and persist in an excessive manner even if the stimuli which evoke the changes have been taken out. So neoplasias are nothing but कोई भी abnormal mass आपके body में जो grow कर रहा है वो useless है, जिसका कोई functions नहीं है आपके body में, वो uncontrolled way में grow कर रहा है और किसी भी चीज से वो ग्रोथ हो रहा है, इवन इफ आप वो चीज को निकाल दो तब भी वो एक्सेसिव मैनर में ग्रो करते जाएगा. इस टाइप के टिश्यू ग्रोथ को हम लोग न्यूप्लेजिया बोलते हैं. सो न्यूप्लेजिया को समटाइम वी आल्सो कॉल्ड इट एज ट्यूमर, एंड इफ यू स्टडी दैट ट्यूमर देन दैट स्टडी इज कॉल्ड एज ऑन्कोलॉजी, एंड जो ऑन्कोलॉजी पढ़ते हैं उनको ऑन्कोलॉजिस्ट बोलते हैं. एंड यू नो न्यूप्लाजम्स कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप, इट कैन बी बेनाइन फॉर्म and it can be a malignant form. Benign and malignant forms are very common terminology. I think aap logo ko sabko pata hi hoga. Phir bhi we will go a little bit further, try to improve a little bit more knowledge about a benign and malignant tumor. So before going towards any form of tumor, we have to know the basic structure. So all benign and malignant form of tumor have two components. एक दो components हमेशा इधर benign हो या फिर malignant हो, दोनों में होता है. एक है parenchyma, दूसरा है stroma. So parenchyma is nothing but it will tell you the behavior of a tumor and also tell you the tumor the area of a tumor which has been derived. From which it has been derived. So that your kind of information can be given by the parenchyma. And stroma, supportive stroma is nothing but it tells you about the surrounding blood vessels, connective tissues of that area. So benign tumors are said to be benign when microscopic, and if you observe that particular tumor both microscopically and gross examinations, if you do, they look relatively innocent and they remain localized. They will not spread from one place to another place. They will not metastasize. And when you surgically remove it, the patient can survive. So, that kind of tumor form is called as benign tumor. And it has been designed or designated by suffix OMA. So, koi bhi, terms OMA se OMA, OMA se end ho raha hai, uska suffix OMA hai. वो बेनाइन ट्यूमर को दर्शाता है. जैसे कि इफ आई टॉक अबाउट फाइब्रस टिश्यू कनेक्ट फाइब्रस टिश्यू रिलेटेड ट्यूमर एंड इफ द टर्म्स आर कॉल्ड एज फाइब्रोमा देन इट कैन बी अ बेनाइन बेनाइन ट्यूमर. सिमिलरली इफ इट इज कॉन्ड्रियोमा देन इट कैन बी अ ट्यूमर विच इज इन बेनाइन फॉर्म ऑफ कार्टिलेजिनियस टिश्यूज. मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर ऑन द अदर हैंड दे आर वेरी एग्रेसिव इन नेचर and they invade and destroy the adjacent structure and they spread from one place to another place and eventually causes the death of a patient. So that kind of characteristics of tumor comes under category of malignant tumor. And malignant tumor ka naam ab hum derive karenge. If you talk about nomenclature for malignant tumor, it can be either have a suffix of carcinoma or can be having a suffix of sarcoma. So sarcoma will be given to a category of a tumor which is in malignant form, but they are of mesenchymal tissue or mesenchymal origin. Similarly, if it is of epithelial tissue or epithelial origin and if it is malignant in form, then it will have a suffix called as sarcoma. Example, jaise ki if somebody is suffering from oral cancer, then if it is in malignant in form, then we call it as oral squamous cell carcinoma. Okay, So now I hope you have a brief idea about malignant and benign tumor, but then there is a classification, so a brief classification is required, and it is very important for your exams also. So in this table, you're going to see like what is the difference between benign and malignant tumor. So if you see, it has been categorized into different categories. First is clinical and gross features. Clinical and gross features, nothing but which can be observed by the naked eye. Microscopic features, which has to be observed under the microscope. Some tumor giant cells, which comes under microscopic examination. Rate of growth, local invasion, metastasis, and prognosis. So if you go through once, you will understand it. But then I will try to let you understand a few points. Wherein, if you talk about clinical and gross features, and if you specifically see the boundaries, so benign jo hota hai, wo hamesha encapsulated and well, well mannered type ka dikhta hai when you observe, by the naked eye. But if in case of malignant, it will be poorly. They have a very zigzag type of structure when you observe with the naked eye. Even if the size is concerned, the size is usually small in case of benign, but it is not in all the cases. But then, and if you talk about malignant, it will often look larger in size. Similarly, if you talk about macroscopic features, macroscopic features or pattern, agar aap dekhoge, तो पैटर्न में जो बनाई है वो यूजुअली रिसेंबल विद द ओरिजिनल वन, माने नॉर्मल से ज्यादा डिफरेंस नहीं होता है, ऑलमोस्ट लाइक सिमिलर विद द नॉर्मल वन. बट इफ इट इज मैलिग्नेंट वन, इट विल नॉट रिसेंबल विद द ओरिजिनल टिश्यू. सिमिलरली इफ यू टॉक अबाउट न्यूक्लियस साइटोप्लाज्मिक रेशियो, साइज ऑफ न्यूक्लियस एंड साइटोप्लाज्म, सो इट लुक समवट नॉर्मल इन केस ऑफ बेनाइन वन, but it is increased in the case of malignant one. Agar aap rate of growth dekhenge to usually slow rehta hai benign, lekin malignant jaldi tarike se rapidly wo progress karta hai. Similarly, metastasis is nothing but invasion or transportation of spread of tumor from one place to another place. So in case of malignant wo usually absent rehta hai, benign mein usually absent rehta hai. But in case of malignant, it is frequently present. So it has a tendency to spread from one place to another place. And if you talk about prognosis, in case of benign one, you have a little bit of complication. But then the complication will not go, in a very severe form when you remove the tumor by a surgical procedure. But then in case of malignant, it can be very complicated and eventually lead to death of a patient. If we talk about tumor classifications, we have seen already it has been divided into benign and malignant tumor. But then you have to know the nomenclature of a tumor how can we differentiate between, through that nomenclature, how can we differentiate between benign and malignant. It is very much important. So agar aap dekhenge yahan mein, to benign ke liye different nomenclature hai, malignant ke liye different nomenclature hai, but origin the origin of a tumor is same. So for example, if you see here, if it is I've told you in malignant, if you talk about nomenclature, it can be either sarcoma or carcinoma. Sarcoma agar wo mesenchymal area se hai ya fir uske cell mesenchymal cell se originated hai to usko hum log sarcoma bolenge. Carcinoma is nothing but it is of epithelial cell origin. सिमिलरली अगर वो बेनाइन है तो उससे उसका सफिक्स ओमा रहता है. ओके, सो इफ यू सी एपिथेलियल ट्यूमर, इफ इट इज स्क्वामस एपिथेलियम, इफ द ट्यूमर इज अकरिंग इन अ स्मॉल स्क्वामस एपिथेलियम एंड इट इज बेनाइन इन फॉर्म, देन वी विल कॉल इट एज स्क्वामस सेल पैपिलोमा. सिमिलरली इफ इट इज स्क्वामस एपिथेलियम लेकिन वो ट्यूमर फॉर्म मैलिग्नेंट निकल गया तो हम लोग उसको बोलेंगे स्क्वामस सेल कार्सिनोमा. सिमिलरली अगर वो हेपेटोसाइट्स है, लिवर सेल्स है, तो बेनाइन फॉर्म का है, तो अगर बेनाइन फॉर्म का है तो हम लोग क्या लिखेंगे, लिवर सेल एडिनोमा. बट अगर वो मेलिग्नेंट फॉर्म का है तो हम लोग हेपाटोमा लिखते हैं, नहीं तो हेपाटोसेलुलर कार्सिनोमा भी लिख सकते हैं. ठीक है, सिमिलरली अगर वो इपिथिलियल रीजन का नहीं है, मेसेनकाइमल रीजन का है, तो टर्मिनोलॉजी में थोड़ा सा चेंजेस आ सकता है. जैसे कि इफ इट इज ऑफ एडिपोज टिश्यू, एंड इफ इट इज बेनाइन फॉर्म देन वी विल कॉल इट लाइपोमा, बट अगर वो मैलिग्नेंट फॉर्म का है तो लाइपोसारकोमा, ठीक है. सिमिलरली अगर वो यू नो कार्टिलेज का है तो कॉन्ड्रियोमा एंड कॉन्ड्रियोसारकोमा, बोन का है तो ऑस्टियोमा एंड ऑस्टियोसारकोमा एंड गो ऑन. सो दैट इज हाउ वी कैन डिफरेंशिएट एंड यू नो बेनाइन एंड मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर अकॉर्डिंग टू द नोमेनक्लेचर दे हैव बीन गिवन. Now we go towards characteristics of tumor. What are the characteristics of tumor and which is very much important? So there are following headings which comes under characteristics of tumor. It is the rate of growth, cancer stem cell, clinical and gross features, microscopic features, local invasion and metastasis. इस सब को हम लोग individually अब पढ़ेंगे, ठीक है. So rate of growth मतलब किस तेजी से ट्यूमर ग्रोथ हो रहा है. सो जनरली अगर आप देखेंगे अकॉर्डिंग टू द नॉर्मल फिजियोलॉजी वन मदर सेल विल गिव राइज टू टू डॉटर सेल, माने एक मदर सेल दो डॉटर सेल को डिवाइड करके देता है अकॉर्डिंग टू माइटोसिस. बट इन केस ऑफ यू नो न्यूप्लेशिया द ग्रोथ इज नॉट अंडर दैट कंट्रोल, सो इट कैन बी गिव राइज टू टू डॉटर सेल और थ्री और फोर और फाइव और सो मेनी. तो जनरली अगर आप देखेंगे तो बेनाइन ट्यूमर जो स्लो ग्रो करता है एज कम्पेयर टू द मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर. एंड जनरेशन टाइम यू नो जो जनरेशन टाइम है या फिर आई वुड से द रैपिडली ग्रोइंग ट्यूमर हैज अ वेरी यू नो टेंड्स टू बी रियली पोली डिफ्रेंशिएटेड, माने जो रैपिडली ग्रो करने वाला ट्यूमर जो है वो poorly differentiated, माने it will not resemble with a normal structure. So जो tumor जल्दी grow कर रहा है वो अपने normal tissue के साथ एकदम resemble नहीं करेगा. See in this picture you can see normal division में what will happen, a mother cell will give rise to two daughter cell, okay, while you know similarly one daughter cell will give rise to two daughter cell. But then if in case of any damage or cell damage is there in the cell cycle in a normal circumstances, then what will happen, there is a DNA repair mechanism which will repair the DNA and make it as successful, or else it will go for cell suicide or apoptosis, meaning it will try to the cell will be, if it cannot be repaired then it will be dead. But in case of cancer cell division aap dekh rahe hai mutated cells grow kar raha hai, fir secondary mutation bhi ho raha hai, fir third mutation bhi ho raha hai, fourth mutation hone ke baad uncontrolled growth ho raha hai. That means what, see you in cancer cell division the rate is also more, at the same time the DNA repair mechanism will not work or it will not go towards cell suicide, it will continuously growing on in an uncontrolled fashion. If you talk about cancer stem cell, so cancer stem cells are nothing but you know the population of you know heterogeneous population of cells contains cancer stem cells. So these particular cells are also called as immotile cells. These cells say for example, like you know the cell has a particular lifespan, so on that specific period of time they will do their function and at the end of the day they will die. But in case of cancer cells and stem cells, they'll become immotile. They will not obey the normal rules and regulations of cell death and cell production. So that is how the cancer cell stem cells are. If you talk about the clinical features, it comes under signs and symptoms. So benign tumor usually remain, they have a little bit of symptoms and generally they are slow growing. But in case of malignant, as I've told you before, they grow rapidly, they ulcerate in the surface, they invade into deeper tissues, they may spread from one place to another place. So they have that two characteristics, the two important characteristics like invasiveness and metastasis, which is not present in a benign form. So these are the common signs and symptoms of benign tumor or cancer metastasis. So headache, seizure, vitiligo, vertigo, cough, lymphadenopathy, hepatomegaly, pain, fracture, spinal cord compressions, etc. can be seen. Gross appearance, if we talk about gross appearance, so that we have seen in that benign and malignant differentiation also. But then yes, if we see the tumor with the naked eye, then benign tumor will look like oval in shape, they are encapsulated, they are freely movable, and they are often firm and uniform. But in case of malignant, they are irregular in shape, and transfer to adjacent site, and they lead to secondary changes like hemorrhage, infraction, ulcerations also. So these are the appearance. So if you see this benign tumor, it will look very nice, neat and clean. They have a thick covering outside. They don't interfere with the other adjacent structure. But then if you see this malignant form of tumor, they lead to hemorrhage. They invade to other vessels, blood vessels, and through lymphatic route or blood route, they try to transfer into another play area. They also causes ulceration of skin, and other changes they can do, and they reach some form of necrosis also. So if we talk about microscopic features, microscopic pattern will come, differentiation and anaplasia will come, tumor angiogenesis, stroma will come, and summative reaction. So microscopic pattern, agar aap dekhe to epithelial tumors arrange in a solid and parallel papillary fashion. Mesenchymal, they look they usually separate from each other using by an intercellular matrix substances. And benign tumor and low grade malignant tumor reduplicate the normal structure. It will almost look like normal structure. So this is very much important, like differentiation. The differentiation is nothing but the how much that particular tissues resemble with the normal one, both morphologically and functionally. So well differentiated and poorly differentiated are the most common terms which you can see under differentiation. So well differentiation means minimal deviation of neoplastic cell in structure and function as compared to the normal cell. So well differentiated means it is somewhat look different, but then it is not that much different with the normal cells. Poorly differentiated means there is poor structure and functional resemblance to the corresponding normal cells. So anaplasia is nothing but sometimes you call it as bad cells also. So now you can see there is a difference between what is the difference between normal morphology and cytomorphology of an anaplasia. So normal cell, there is a basal polarity, and in abnormal cells there is lots of basal polarity. There is no pleomorphism. There is some pleomorphism. There is variation in the cell size and shape. So, nucleocytoplasmic ratio is low, but in case of anaplasia, it is high. Nuclear chromatin normal hai, nuclear hyperchromatin hai. Similarly, there is no giant cells. Out here, you can see tumor giant cells. So, cytoplasm will look normal, but then in case of this, you can see this increased mucin. So, these are called as anaplasia. So, anaplasia, yes, the same thing we have, which you have seen in the earlier slides. It has got same description, and local invasion and direct spread. Local invasion and direct spread is nothing but when a tumor is growing into a specific area, how much larger it is growing every day. That kind of spread, or maybe like if they are growing in a very speed fashion and they are growing bigger in their size, then it can interfere or they can occupy the adjacent space for other organ. So in case of benign, I told you before, it will remain like encapsulated. It might extend the size and push aside the surrounding normal tissue, but they will never invade, infiltrate, and metastasize. But in case of malignant tumor, yes, they will grow abnormally and they will extend and push aside the normal surrounding tissue. At the same time, they will invade, infiltrate, and metastasize to surrounding adjacent or into a distant site also. Metastasis is nothing but spread of cancer cell from one place to another place or from one place to distant sites. So in case of benign tumor, they are not metastasized, but there are few cases are there which has a tendency to spread from one place to another place, especially with the benign tumor of central nervous system. But then yes, but the malignant tumor has a tendency to spread from one place to another place, and they will they will spread from one place to another place by these three routes, which are lymphatic spread, hematogenous spread, or spread through body cavities and natural passage. So these are the route through which the metastasis of malignant tumor can occur. this is for this video. In this video, we're going to see the different grading and staging of tumor. At the same time, we're also going to see what are the carcinogenic agents which are responsible for causing cancer. So if you have any kind of question, please write in the comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you.